Hello, I am Mairéad Nayager, Chief HR Officer for Diageo. I joined the company in 2006 and have held roles across Africa and Europe before being appointed to my current role in 2015. In this presentation, I will bring to life Diageo's unique culture, and with the help of Hina Nagarajan, our Managing Director and CEO of United Spirits in India, and John Kennedy, our President of Europe and India, we will provide examples of our culture in action, driving Diageo's performance and creating competitive advantage. Today, Diageo is a brand and consumer-obsessed organization, delivering strong performance and growth with a restlessness to always do better. We have an accessible purpose to celebrate life every day, everywhere, providing an holistic platform for us to be the best we can be at work, at home, and in our communities. And an inspiring performance ambition to become the best performing, most trusted and respected consumer products company with clear, consistent business priorities driving high performance expectations. All of which is underpinned by strong values rooted in competence and character. In this presentation, we will show how the passion our people have for our brands and their engagement with our purpose and performance ambition creates an ownership mentality, fueling our desire to be the closest company to consumers and customers. We will show how we are building agile, solutions-oriented teams able to meet the needs of our consumers and customers and drive growth. And we will show how we are winning and retaining talent in a fiercely competitive market. Achieving our performance ambition means delivering efficient growth and value creation for our shareholders while doing business the right way for all of our stakeholders. Our people are the single biggest determinant of our success and critical to the delivery of the strong outcomes underpinning our leveraged growth model, which Lavanya will discuss in her presentation shortly. All of our 27,650 employees are very clear on the role they play in driving performance, both on the top and bottom line. For example, in our most recent global employee survey in fiscal 21, 84% of employees said they see a clear link between their work and Diageo's immediate business priorities. This is 13% higher than the external benchmark. In addition, 84% of employees said they know what they can do to help Diageo win market share. Clarity of strategy and engagement has been key to the consistency of our performance delivery. Our people are highly engaged. A recent survey showed 89% of our employees are proud to work for Diageo. Our overall engagement score increased by 1 percentage point to 81%, and our employer advocacy score has risen by 5 points since 2019. And just as our organic net sales have grown over the last 5 years, setting aside F20 for COVID, of course, our 81% overall engagement score is not a one-off. Overall engagement has increased since fiscal 2017. High levels of engagement across the organization drives accountability for performance delivery. Our people feel and act like owners, no matter the circumstances or barriers they face. Two of my favorite examples of this are from either side of the world. The first took place last year at the start of the pandemic. Our team at the Guinness Open Gate Brewery in Baltimore, Maryland, needed to close their doors to the public due to statewide lockdown. The local team decided to pivot operations to help feed the local community by baking and donating bread for the Maryland Food Bank. 12,000 loaves of brewery bread were baked, with 500 loaves donated each week. They also launched a successful curbside beer pickup program to enable local fans to try new beers in a safe, convenient way, with all net proceeds over $35,000 benefiting the same Maryland Food Bank. Today, this is a sizable incremental business for the brewery. Alongside local craft beers brewed at the Open Gate, the team extended their innovation to partnerships with local community leaders to make beers inspired by the flavors of their unique cultures and celebrate local diversity. It is this combination of craft and purpose that sets Guinness apart and has helped drive its market share to 3 times the national average. The second example is from Australia, where in March this year, extreme rainfall on the east coast of Australia led to devastating and widespread flooding in New South Wales. A particularly hard-hit customer was Celebrations Wingham, whose store was completely flooded. Diane Jutterham, their Diageo sales rep, went to help straight away, and she stood side by side with them, helping to clean up the store and recover. They were able to open again in just 18 days. in no small part thanks to Diane's sense of community, ownership and purpose. These are just two of the countless stories of our purpose and culture in action through the pandemic. Being obsessed with consumers requires us to have diversity of backgrounds and experience in our talent base. We are committed to creating the most inclusive and diverse culture, not just because it's the right thing to do, but because we believe this commitment allows us to recruit and retain the best employees, achieve better performance, and have a greater impact on society. Today, almost two-thirds of our executive committee members are homegrown talent with substantial experience in multiple roles across various markets. Each has worked in at least three different markets or regions, and as a result, has a broad view of our consumer and customer base. We are building deeper ethnic diversity within our business. 37% of our global leadership population are ethnically diverse, with eight nationalities represented on our board and executive committees. 11 years ago, the Diageo Executive Committee were all men. Today, women make up 60% of the Diageo board and 38% of the Executive Committee. And globally, 42% of our leadership population are women. Increasing diversity should be led from the top, but the responsibility for change and the benefits therein must be felt by the whole organisation for it to be sustainable. In February, we announced specific performance measures and targets as part of the Diageo long-term incentive plan for our leadership population to drive clearer accountability for progress on diversity. With stretching goals to transform gender and ethnic leadership representation, we believe we will deepen our connection to our consumers, retain and recruit the best talent, and increase preference for our brands. We are among the first companies to create such a clear link and direct accountability for our total ESG commitments with our senior management community. We believe the ultimate competitive advantage for any company is a culture that is able to adapt quickly to changing conditions and to finding new ways to succeed with customers and consumers. Our operating model is designed to ensure market general managers are fully accountable and agile in the decisions they make based on local consumer insight and performance opportunity, while of course leveraging the best of what Diageo creates globally when it comes to tools, technology, capabilities and insights. As Lavanya will discuss later, over the last 5 years, we have delivered significant savings in overheads that have been reinvested in areas to drive growth. And we've also created a simpler, more accountable organisation for our people. As an example, we have significantly improved our spans of control that define how many direct reports a manager or leader has, moving from an historical average of under 4 direct reports per manager to 7.2 today has driven greater autonomy and faster decision-making across the organisation. We are building a culture that empowers every employee to take personal ownership for everyday efficiencies and acting on barriers that get in the way of performing at their best. We launched Radical Liberation earlier this year to fuel culture that enables speed by taking rapid action to reduce and stop processes and activities that do not add value, add complexity, and drain the energy of our people. For example, we've simplified and automated controls for our travel and expenses reimbursement approval process, which has led to a 95% reduction in line manager approvals in less than a month. By removing excessive line manager approvals for IT equipment, annual leave requests, and by simplifying processes such as resourcing and procurement, we are freeing up time, energy, and focus. Across nearly 28,000 employees, that really makes a difference. The way Diageo is structured is testament to our consumer centricity. 71% of our total employees are directly involved in the production, distribution, marketing, and selling of our products. 75% of employees in our markets work in the front office, for example, sales and marketing. And this number jumps to 80% plus when we include our third-party sales teams in markets such as North America. Our operating model gives the general managers of our markets the freedom to win locally and ensures we stay as close as possible to consumers and customers. You'll hear from John shortly on how we have reorganized our European business to get even closer to consumers and customers. We channel our resources to the highest growth opportunities at speed. Overall, we've added 90 new roles into the US and China in the last few years to seize opportunities in those key markets to drive performance and deliver results. In China, some of these new roles support our new state-of-the-art R&D center in Shanghai, the first of its kind in the beverage alcohol sector in Shanghai, together with the recent opening of our major logistics hub in Shenzhen. In the US, we created a new team to drive the North America RTD strategy to go after the significant opportunity we see in the convenience category. Across our business, we have established agile ways of working, where we bring cross-functional teams together to work on our biggest priorities. We call these sprints, and they align to our quarterly goal setting, which I'll come back to. Later, John and Hina will share examples of how teams in Europe and India have moved quickly to reallocate resources, which is fueling a culture of speed and agility. Now, I want to share two examples from other markets across our business, Uganda and Colombia. In Uganda, in less than 4 months, a cross-functional e-commerce team created and implemented a disruptive strategy of using Boda Boda motorbikes for the last mile delivery of our brands to consumers during the COVID lockdown. This led to more than double the NSV from the e-commerce channel in Q1 F21. In F22, NSV growth from this channel is expected to more than double again year on year. And in Colombia, we've reassigned 35% of our organization to the biggest business opportunities, including e-com. This led to e-commerce NSV growth from 2% to 8% of sales and gave our people the opportunity to develop new digital capabilities. Through these focused cross-functional teams, our people are gaining critical new skills while delivering work that's adding value quickly to some of our highest priorities. Looking ahead, we will continue to rapidly reallocate resources to enable the development of new capabilities, including data analytics, and strengthening our route to consumer in key markets such as North America and China to support our future growth ambitions. We take this focus on agility right through to our incentive programs. As part of the consideration of appropriate annual and long-term incentive outcomes, we consider performance against financial metrics and actions taken by leaders and employees to protect the longer-term interest of the business. Our annual incentive program, or AIP, performance measures and targets are reviewed carefully every year to align with the business strategy and ever-changing market conditions. We have made changes to our AIP structure in all but two of the past 8 years to reflect the priorities in a given year, while keeping constant the key performance measures of NSV and operating profit. For example, in F21, we introduced market share as a modifier and incentivized all employees against total Diageo performance targets rather than individual markets. This facilitated speed of reinvestment and allocation of resources across the globe to help the business emerge strongly. And to complement the introduction of sprints to our ways of working in F21, we shifted our performance management framework from half-yearly performance conversations to quarterly goals, clearly linked to our performance ambition. This has increased the focus on everyday, in-the-moment performance for teams. We believe these changes supported our delivery, enabling us to hold or grow our off-trade share in approximately 85% of measured markets in F21. At Diageo, we have a strong pipeline of experienced talent with deep knowledge about the business. In the last 3 years, an average of 70% of our internal leadership roles were filled by internal talent. And since July 2020, 4 out of 6 appointments to the executive committee were internal promotions. We focus our external talent acquisition at leadership levels on bringing in new capabilities in areas such as digital and e-com, while also building greater diversity. In F21, 56% of external hires into our leadership population were women, and 44% were ethnically diverse. Increasingly, we are also hiring external talent from broader industries, especially for new capabilities such as digital, data, and analytics. We have created a distinctive employer brand, which enables us to attract talent from leading consumer-focused companies, as well as from other sectors, including major technology companies. We have high standards for leadership and talent. For example, at the point of recruitment, we benchmark our leaders against the top quartile of leaders from FTSE 100 companies. This allows us to hire only the best talent. We hire leaders for Diageo first, leaders who have the potential for bigger roles or those with new skill sets. In the last 18 months, 77% of our most senior leaders have joined us from large multinationals. Talent retention within our leadership population is strong, with only around 2% regrettable attrition in the last 12 months. And in our recent employee survey, two-thirds of leaders told us that the quality of our brands, people, and leadership development were the main reasons they joined Diageo. We firmly believe we are retaining and recruiting talent in a fiercely competitive market as a result of our culture, purpose, and performance ambition. Hina will now show how the passion of our people and their level of engagement has transformed our business in India.
Hello, I'm Hina Nagarajan, and I am the MD and CEO of United Spirits Limited, Diageo's business in India. Prior to taking up this role, I ran Africa regional markets for 2.5 years, having joined Diageo in 2018. Mairéad talked about the extraordinary passion and engagement of our people globally, and Diageo India is no exception. Our culture has been transformed by igniting the power of purpose within the business and empowering individuals and teams. This has enabled bold performance delivery along with significant productivity savings. While our business results are a strong measure, our own employee survey results from May 2021 are testimony to how engaged our employees are. At 88%, overall engagement has increased 2 points since 2019. 93% of employees are proud to work for Diageo, and 87% of our employees would recommend working at Diageo to others, up 6 points versus 2019. And 93% of our employees know what they need to do to help Diageo win market share. An example to illustrate this is when our East Region team turned the COVID disruption into an opportunity in West Bengal. They unlocked the home delivery channel in a short period of time. A cross-functional team co-created policy with regulators and energized the retailers to participate. End of F21, 300 plus retailers had signed up, 20% of prestige segment sales in the state came from this channel, and we won significantly against competition. Speed, agility, and empowerment are the key pillars of our culture. Let me share a few examples with you. Post the COVID lockdown last year, our biggest challenge was to restart operations in line with stringent government guidelines. We empowered our employees to share ideas, which enabled us to be the fastest in the industry to restart and ramp up our capacity to almost 100% of pre-COVID levels within 3 weeks. This helped us rebuild our business rapidly and outperform competition. In previous years, it would take on average 18 months to bring new innovation products to market. In 2021, thanks to strong consumer insights applied at pace, we were able to understand the opportunity, disrupt our conventional ways of working, and create a new limited edition whiskey in 85 days from idea to delivery. A sprint team, empowered and non-hierarchical, acted with an entrepreneurial mindset, committed to its purpose of rapid innovation. They behaved like founders, making quick decisions. The India leadership team changed engagement from reviews to enablement and simplified the innovation process to manage risks while enabling speed. This experiment has created a significant new business growth opportunity, Indian craft, and with it, exciting new ways of working for USL. We are now using sprints to drive powerful outcomes across several critical business mandates, and our business performance in F21 is a strong proof point of our new ways of working. We outperformed the competition in F21 with reported NSV growth of 13%, including 18% growth in Scotch and 41% growth for Johnnie Walker. We were also able to generate productivity savings of almost £17 million ahead of target, despite the commodity price escalation and challenges presented by COVID-19. In a traditionally male-dominated industry, inclusion and diversity has been an important pillar of our performance ambition in India. In the last 7 years, we have made tremendous progress in this area. With confidence, I can say that we lead the India marketplace in our policies, practices, and outlook on inclusion and diversity. Today, 50% of the USL executive committee in India are women. There were no women in leadership roles in 2014. And as a female CEO, I am proudly standing here representing the change we have brought about. 50% of our hires in the last 18 months are women. Across our overall employee base, female representation has changed from 6.6% to 22.5% in the last 6 years. In this year's employee survey, our inclusion and diversity index score is strong at 86%. And 87% of our people believe they can be themselves and thrive at Diageo, a rise of 2% versus 2019. As producers of some of the country's best loved brands, we know we can make a difference in culture by changing the narrative for our brands and by showing progressive portrayals of gender and inclusivity in line with what we stand for as a business. Whether it is changing Yari, friendship, by making it universal and gender agnostic through McDowell's Number One, or bringing a strong message of women's individuality through Black and White, our brands represent inclusion. Our recent Challenge Accepted campaign from Royal Challenge featured women cricketers promoting equality by accepting the challenge to play the first mixed gender cricket match. Let's watch.
That day is coming. Get ready. Get some new chance, because you're getting some new stars. Make room in the dressing room. Make space in your mind, because the day is coming. Maybe we'll get hit in the face, maybe we'll lose face. Or maybe not. We're not here to win. We are here to begin. And it's true, today men and women don't share the field. But who knows about tomorrow? Because if the world needs to get equal, the bold need to get started. Everyone says this is a huge challenge. Of course it is. But you know what we say? Challenge accepted.
Our purpose also comes to life through the way we are meeting our responsibilities to our communities, society, and the environment. To promote positive drinking, we partnered with Network 18 to launch a nationwide anti-drink and drive awareness campaign reaching nearly 90 million people. We have also trained almost 235,000 people in 300 schools across 15 states on the dangers of underage drinking. By 2030, we intend to change the attitudes of 800,000 people to drink driving in partnership with the United Nations Institute for Training and Research. We intend to educate 1.5 million young people, parents and teachers on the dangers of underage drinking, and will reach 2 million people with responsible drinking messages. By 2030, we also intend to provide business and hospitality skills to 12,000 people through our Learning for Life and skills programs. Environmentally, we are also challenging ourselves to do more and more. We have replenished almost 408,000 cubic meters of water across our water-stressed areas, improved our water use efficiency by 55%, reduced carbon emissions by 95%, and collected 20,000 metric tons of plastic waste. By 2026, we have also committed to replenish more water than we use in our operations. All our operations will be net zero by 2025, and we will be plastic positive by end F22. Meaning we will be collecting more plastic than we put out. Our business in India has undergone significant transformation in recent years. Our culture is strong, our people highly engaged in our performance ambition, and proud to work for a company that can deliver sustainable, inclusive performance in the right way from grain to glass. John will now explain how our Europe business has been transformed to get even closer to consumers.
Thanks, Hina. Hello, I'm John Kennedy, President of Europe and India. In Europe, we're also building a culture where extraordinary engagement drives performance. I'll focus particularly on how our people have worked with agility and speed to drive significant success coming through the pandemic. Pre-COVID, the Europe business started from a strong base as the best performing major total beverage alcohol company over a 5-year period. For a number of years, we had operated with a One Europe structure, which had allowed us to drive major efficiency gains and implement best practice in many areas. Yet we believed there was more opportunity for growth by getting even closer to local consumers and customers. We therefore took the decision to move from the One Europe structure to create our new 6-market model. We announced the new organization in March 2020, during the week Italy and Great Britain implemented their first major COVID lockdowns. In that environment, with no travel and no in-person meetings, we completed consultations in dozens of countries, resourced 2,000-plus roles, and hired 18 senior-level external leaders. Critically, we stood up full marketing departments in Budapest, Hamburg, Amsterdam, and Madrid for the first time. We also advanced on our I&D goals, moving from 42% to 52% of leadership roles filled by women through this change. We successfully launched our new market structure on time 3 months later on July 1st. Our new local leadership teams were given the freedom to succeed and a simple brief, which was to emerge stronger from the pandemic. We implemented the new quarterly performance management system and market share metrics to ensure everybody was focused on a fast-moving external environment. Let me walk through examples of how a number of markets successfully tackled this challenge. In Great Britain, as consumers shifted to relaxing at home, the team pivoted to the whiskey category, which leads on these occasions. Building and implementing new plans across Johnny Walker, Haig Club, Bulleit, Talisker, and Bell's has led to a 330 basis point share increase in the category for Diageo. We also spearheaded the growth of no alcohol spirits with the launch of Gordon and Tanqueray 0.0, creating excitement and momentum. In Great Britain overall, Diageo's share of the spirits market in the last 3 months is 410 basis points above 2 years ago. In Northern Europe, going into the pandemic, the gin and aperitif categories were accelerating fast as the early evening drinking occasion grew. The gin category had grown 29% in the previous 2 years. So the team ramped up their innovation plan, including the launch of Tanqueray Royale and Gordon's Sicilian Lemon, as well as tripling media investment to drive a 370 basis point increase in Diageo's category share. And overall, Diageo's share of the spirits market in Northern Europe has increased by 59 basis points compared to 2 years ago. In Southern Europe, whiskey has been our top priority. And with our new organization model, we've recruited high-quality local marketing talent and are seeing this translate into strong creative platforms. Johnny Walker's Keep Walking Together campaign focuses on promoting the return of live music and supporting the musician community. The local insight has been that artists and musicians are seen as having contributed significantly to helping people get through COVID and deserve to be supported in recovery. We've formed partnerships with Danny Martin in Spain, Fedez in Italy, and Konstantinos Argyros in Greece, each iconic and highly visible artists. And the creative content has struck a chord in each country. Overall, our spirits market share in Southern Europe has grown by 68 basis points. And in Ireland, we experienced one of the longest pub lockdowns in Europe. Diageo has stepped in as a lead supporter to the on-trade with our Raise the Bar program, providing essential support for publicans throughout the island. We've provided training and upskilling courses, as well as supporting mental health for hospitality workers, with 22,000 participating to date. We've supported the design of safe outdoor spaces for over 1,200 publicans, with over 6,000 weatherproof pagodas, barrels, umbrellas, and windbreakers installed so far. And during shutdown, all of the Guinness storehouse staff switched to working as merchandisers in grocery stores. And when we reopened, a series of events to support the local community were put in place. All frontline workers were given free admission as a thank you, and over 8,000 frontline staff visited. Clona Sexton, a nurse from Cork, was the first visitor when we reopened, and that story was splashed across the national media. These efforts put Guinness at the heart of the conversation about recovery and reopening. And we've seen a genuine surge of goodwill for the Guinness brand, with share up 400 basis points in the on-trade versus pre-COVID and 251 basis points in the off-trade. In Ireland, as in other markets, Diageo's spirits market share has also increased, up 22 bips. Here's the Guinness ad we ran as pubs started to reopen a few months ago. I think it's a brilliant demonstration of the passion, creativity, and imagination that our teams continue to bring to their work every day. Take a look.
Quite as often as I could have. Little things I should have said and done. I just never took the time. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
Now, like Hina in India, I'm also delighted with the progress our people have continued to make, bringing our purpose to life across our ESG goals in Europe. Just in the last year, we've trained 2,800 people for a career in hospitality through Learning for Life. We've educated 67,000 young people on the dangers of underage drinking through our Smash program and reached 79 million consumers with messages of moderation. And all of this has been delivered through passionate, engaged people. The evidence demonstrates that our teams are focused and feel accountable for delivery. In our annual employee survey, 9 months after the launch of the new markets, 93% of our people in Europe said they know what they can do to help Diageo win market share. And the ownership mentality is well embedded in Europe, with 84% of our employees saying that the people around them take accountability for business outcomes. This marks a 7-point improvement versus 2019. The changes we've made in Europe are working well. They brought us closer to our consumers and customers and enabled even greater pace across the business. As Mairéad, Hina, and I have hopefully illustrated, Diageo's progressive culture is providing us with significant competitive advantage. The passion of our purpose and our brands, the celebration of inclusion and diversity, and the value we place on speed and agility are distinct and advantageous and will continue to drive our performance in the future. Thank you.